Hallo.
Jason, what's good?
God is good.
Hey man, this is it, man. This is it.
Okay.
This is the show, man. Welcome to the show. I appreciate you, man.
Thanks. You too.
I bet. Look, everybody, welcome to the show, man. This is On Call with Danele, where I interview artists, influencers, you know, game changers, people who just keep their dreams alive. And I'm super excited, super honored to have Jayzo as a guest. Jayzo is an artist from Darkless. Jayzo, tell the people who you are.
Okay, my name is Jayzo, but my real name is Shodi.
Yes, sir.
I started rapping on the age of 10 years, started writing songs, but I didn't really show it to anyone till I was 13 years old. And I started performing at high school.
Wow.
Yeah, so that's what I did.
Were you nervous when you first performed? Was that your first performance?
Yeah, that was my first performance, and I was really nervous.
Oh.
Yeah, I didn't want to mess anything up, you see.
And how did the crowd take it? Was it easy, besides being you nervous, was it easy to perform?
Yeah, the crowd really helped me because they cheered for me. So I felt comfortable and just go with the flow.
Yeah. Did you open for any artists or were you like the main act?
I was the main act, actually.
Yes, sir.
Because I performed with my crew and I opened, like, an I split first.
Opened the show.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir. Do you only rap in English or do you have Afrikaans tracks too?
Nah, I only rap in English.
You speak Afrikaans?
Yeah.
How many languages do you speak, my guy?
Only two, Afrikaans and English.
Sir, and who do you look up to? Like, is there any artist in South Africa or globally that you look up to?
I look up to Iris.
Wow.
And in South Africa, I look up to Iris.
Yes, sir.
And sometimes Shane Eagle also makes me happy with his music. So, only two rappers in South Africa.
You know what, man? There, on the show, there has been 2 to 3 people that says they are a fan of Aries, or in other words, they look up to Aries. Like, Aries is really, really somebody that inspires a lot of guys, man. So I got a question based on that, right, which I ask most of my guests on the show. If Aries were to say now, yo, I want to go on a track with you, would you go with him?
Absolutely, I would go.
Would you murder him on the track or would you go soft on the track? Would you just
never.
Be...
Huh? I will never go soft on him, never.
Ah!
I want to go better than him. The people should see who I am.
Wow, wow, wow. So you would go on the track, beast mode,
yeah.
Murdering the track.
Yes. I'm young, but I have that. I'm young, but I can kill anything.
Oh, that's dope, man. That's a lot of inspiration right there. And I'm sure, like, he's listening to this right now. So while he's listening, what message do you have or what would you like to ask him? Is that, if there's one question that you would like to ask Aries right now, what would that question be?
That question would be, how did it feel? How did it feel when he made his first target empty?
When he made his first track.
Yeah, in the game, in the real game.
Is it that song of Did It or Couldn't? What's it called, Couldn't?
Yes, that song.
Oh, okay. Reese, do you hear? I'm pretty sure, like, he'll respond on Twitter, he'll respond. But, man, I'm super excited to have you on the show, and I'm really, really grateful, Jayzo. Tell the people what's the meaning of your name, Jayzo. How did you go about finding that name of yours?
I found my name. Actually, it's a funny story because Yes, I started my first songs. I started writing R&B songs, and
you can sing.
I sing. Yeah, I also sing.
Wow.
The first song I made my crew. It was a joyful song. I sing the chorus. I didn't write it. I sing it. So,
bro.
I found my name in the love of R&B, I guess.
And then you like, you, cause your name is Jody too, right?
Yeah.
You took it from Jody, or is it just something different?
Nah, I took it from Jody and mixed it with my other name. So,
right, blessed man, blessed. And so right now there are high school learners that are listening to you right now. Is there anything that you would like to tell them, especially your fans from Douglas, bro? What would you like to tell them right now?
I would like to tell them, don't give up on your dreams. Be who you are. Even if you're young, you can still make it. Don't let people push you down.
One point.
Listen to the haters. Be yourself.
One point. And recently you have recorded a song.
Yeah.
Young Boys Up. What inspires you to write that song, my guy? Like, what motivated you to write that song? And you're not alone on that song. Tell the people who are you featuring on that song.
I'm featuring Akito. We in the same crew, Future Kings. Kind of, we all best friends in that crew. So, the inspiration I got from that song is seeing us as young rappers. There's not a lot of young rappers who can do what we do. So, we put it in a song, make other people be inspired by it so they can also be start young and not start when they not get regrets when they get young older.
Wow.
So they can start everything young, at a young age.
Wow.
The earlier, better.
And are you going to release that song anytime soon? Because people are waiting, man.
Maybe going to listen to it soon, yeah.
Incredible and on point at the same time, because I asked one of my guests, I asked Blazy on my show, I asked her, yo, because she looks up to Rhapsody, right, a female artist,
okay.
And I asked her, which is the same question I ask you, would you murder Aries or not, right? And I asked her, would you murder Rhapsody or not? Both of y'all's answers were like similar and the same. So my question right now would be, you get an opportunity to share a stage with Aries.
Yeah.
And, like, you know that you're going to perform before Aries perform. Would you go and rap a hype song, or would you go and rap a love song? What kind of song would you go and perform if you were to open up for Aries?
I would rap a hip-hop song.
Yeah.
Fresh, a song that everybody knows so they can feel me, you see?
Yes, sir.
You should feel the lyrics. You should feel the lyrics.
Is Aries the only person that you would like to feature, like, in South Africa right now? Because I promise you, my guy, I heard you said Shane Eagle, too. Like, Shane Eagle, you said Shane Eagle and Aries are the guys that you look up to. Now, who are the guys that you would like to feature in the game right now? It can be like international artists as well.
Okay, it would be MT.
Yes, sir.
You already know Aries, and then it would be Shane Eagle, J. Cole.
Yes, sir.
Kendrick and Joyner, Dex,
yes, sir.
Hobson, and Tom McDonald. That would be my features that I really would like to be featured.
Wow, man. Wow. And you know what's the mission of this show, right? Is to keep our dreams alive, right? While we are talking, we are really like putting ourselves in our dreams, and we are imagining ourselves, right? And we are living our dreams. And I call artists like who are really pushing the boundaries, who are really grinding, my guy. You know? So, and what we're going through right now is the coronavirus. Are you scared of the coronavirus? Is the coronavirus making you scared for not writing your songs?
Nah, I'm not scared of that. I'm still writing while the coronavirus is here in our land. So I'm releasing another song after Young Boys.
Yes, sir.
That song, R&B. And you already know my song, Hate On Me. So
yes, sir.
Yeah.
Like, you still have a dream, you still have a vision, even though people are saying the coronavirus is going to kill us, this is the end of the world, you still have your dream in you, right?
Yeah, I trust in God, man.
Hey, for reals, bro, for reals. I appreciate that so much, man. Because right now, somebody's going through the most, and that person is not feeling well. Let me ask you this question. This person is your age. Exactly your age.
Okay.
Right? Now, this person is not going to school. This person is not in school. Right? This person dropped out of school. Is there anything that you would like to tell this person, man?
I would tell them...
Like, this person is your age right now.
Okay. He's not old enough to go back. He should go back. Fulfill his dreams. Maybe he could be the president of South Africa. We don't know. You should take a shot. You should take a shot and go back. Try. Don't focus what other people are going to tell you, why you dropped out and all that. They're going to put pressure on you. Of course, they're going to put pressure on you. But don't let it get to you. Don't let it get to you.
Yes, sir.
Be yourself.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Where would you like to go? Where do you see yourself in the next 5-10 years performing? In what parts of the world do you see yourself, like, living your life out?
I see myself in LA right now.
Hey.
LA performing at a crowded, very crowded.
Hey. that crowded where, I don't know if you know what Joyner Lucas did. He jumped on top of his fans, and his fans was like, Versailles, what do
we
do? You're talking about that crowded.
Yeah, I'm talking about that crowded.
Yes, sir. And which other place do you see yourself?
Chicago, New York, and most importantly, I really would like to perform in Dallas with Naomi. Yeah. So.
Yes, sir. And any artists from Douglas besides El Kido that you really see like, no, this guy or this dudes, they have potential, and these guys are gonna take the industry by force. Any guys from Douglas that you see has potential too?
Yeah, I see Young Tommy Gun. He's also a friend of mine. He's a future king.
Yeah.
Young Tommy Gun. And I see World Ray. Juicy B,
yes,
Jungle,
sir.
But Jungle, I don't think he's really serious, but he's good at it. What he's doing, he's good at it.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Is there any artist that you would like to shout out?
Yeah.
Like, just holler at them. Let them know what you think and how you feel. Like, tell them hi. Say hi to anybody that you would like to say hi to, my guy.
Anybody,
my guy. It can be your J. Cole, it can be Mr. President, it can be, I don't know, Steve Harvey, anybody, or it can be anybody from Douglas or Kimberly. Shout out to anybody that you would like to shout out to, man.
I would like to shout out to my mother and father.
Yes, sir.
I want them to know I'm rising quicker than lightning.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, that's... In actual fact, my guy, to be honest with you, that's real right there. You are just being honest and real right there, and I respect that. You know, a lot of the times I wouldn't have even think of, like, shout out to my mom and my dad, because my mom, like, honestly, my mom and my dad, they're not the internet guys, you know. So the fact that you thought about them, even though they're not really much on social media, that's huge right there. So big ups to you on that, man.
Thanks, bro.
I bet, man. Any last words that you have?
Nah, I don't have last words. So
I bet, man. I bet. Well, we've come to the end of the show. Thank you so much for being on the show, my guy. Everybody, this is On Call with Danny Lair. See you on the next episode. Let's go.
J-Lo, out.